It is a well-known fact that truck drivers have a low life expectancy. Unfortunately, truckers are more likely to face health issues, including obesity, diabetes, heart disease, stroke, and many other issues that come with a sedentary lifestyle. That's why we decided to ask our drivers for their advice on staying healthy while being on the road.
When I'm stopped or start my day in the morning, I will prepare my crock pot. And by the time I park, I have an excellent meal to eat. Healthy, I know what's in it. Eating a burger is nice. I enjoy eating those too. But a salad will make you feel 100 times better.
I grocery shop once a week, so I only buy exactly what I'm gonna use for that week. And once I get back to the truck, I'll pre-cook my meals. I freeze two and I keep a couple in the fridge. And I eat those through the week. And by the time it's ready to do a reset again, my fridge is pretty much empty and I'm ready to go grocery shopping again. I got a multivitamin I take. The other one I kind of use a lot is at Love's Truck Stops. It's called Emergency. And I mix it in a bottle of water. I drink one every 2 days and there's 1,000 milligrams of vitamin C. So it keeps the cold away, hopefully COVID as well.
My wife and I take the time before I go out and we prepare all of my meals for the time that I'm gonna be out. Cooked at home, they go into Tupperware containers, everything gets portioned, they go either into the freezer or they go into the fridge, and it comes in the truck, and I eat probably 98% of everything out of my truck. That way I know what I'm eating, I'm watching my sodium intake, I'm watching calories, I'm not gorging. I drink a lot of water, that's the other important thing. As long as you're not drinking it in large quantities, if you're just taking a mouthful here and there just to keep your lips wet and just to get some water into you, you can go 4, 5, 6 hours and then have your bathroom break and you'll be okay.
I think the proactive practices that drivers can take advantage of to improve their health are very similar to the ones that I probably have to take advantage of because I also have a sedentary lifestyle. I sit behind a desk all day. One of the easiest things to do is to change your snacking. Invest in some bags of nuts, get yourself some fresh fruit, spend that time on your reset, cutting it up, put it in the fridge, have it ready. Get yourself some Ziploc bags and put some apple slices in it. I mean, I know it's not as convenient necessarily as just whipping over to the side of the road and grabbing a donut, but it will in the long run benefit you. A higher fiber diet, lower salt, lower fat diet is going to really help with your health.
Many of my friends always ask me, Joe, you've been doing trucking for so long and you doesn't put any weight. All I told them, I just watch what I eat. I don't go any places and buy any food at all because your health, it depends what you eat. And that's what I do. I try to eat the right food. Every weekend or whenever I leave home, I always live with healthy food. My wife will cook enough for me to last me at least a week.
Stay away from potatoes. Potatoes, rice, anything starchy. That's where you are going to pack weight on. At my heaviest, I was 260 pounds. I'm now down to 235, 234, and I'm on my way down to about 220.
Exercising is difficult. I have a skipping rope that I bring with me that I skip from time to time. Not every day, but I do skip. And that allows me to do my cardio while I'm on the road. I am in the flatbed division, which allows me to work a little extra from time to time to tighten down my loads.
A lot of people have gym memberships that they can go to, but you can't always get to one of those gyms. So what I've done is I just brought a couple of weights into the truck with me. There's also resistance bands that you can get for the trucks. I just try and do 20 minutes every morning, every evening. Keeps my body flowing. I want to be active, I want to be healthy. When I go home for my week off, I run around with the kids whilst they're on their bikes.
Because of the ailments I have, my back, I don't have the time to go to a gym, but I can't lift weights, I can't do certain things. So exercise for me is being, at least getting active. Walking, when I'm at home, we live in the country, my wife likes to walk as well. So we will take the dogs, we'll go for a long walk. And like I said before, it's not important, you don't need to power walk. I'm a 230 pound guy. If I power walked, I'm gonna make it to the street there and collapse. So, but enough to get my heart elevated. Some guys stop for their half hour, they jump in the back, they walk at their phone, they do whatever. Get out of your truck. Get out of your truck, do a walk around. First of all, make sure your truck is okay, your trailer's okay, your load is secure. But then get active, go for a walk, go do something, whatever. But get out of the truck, get your body moving, get your blood moving.
For me, I mean, just to keep fit, I've switched over to the flatbed division so I get a little more exercise that way, keep the body moving. On resets, I like to just keep to myself, go for walks.
I know when it comes to exercise, that might be a whole different story. You don't want to look, be the only guy in the parking lot doing yoga at 8 o'clock in the morning at the Flying J. But definitely park further away from the showers. Make that your exercise, walk. If you can do exercise in the cab, take advantage of your time when, you know, you can sit for 10, 15 minutes, do some stretching, maybe get some resistance bands. Those are easy to use in a small, confined environment. All of these things are relatively simple to implement and may go a long way in improving your health.
Smoking is a huge killer for us. It's also, you know, you got heart disease, lung disease, you got cancer. You're just stacking the odds against you by smoking, especially in a truck. And the hours we work, I could start work at 7 a.m, but I'm not gonna go to bed sometimes till 11 o'clock at night. Or I could be awake at 7 a.m. and I won't be in bed till 11 o'clock at night. The hours we work, I drive during the day, I drive during the night, I drive in the middle of the day. All of those, if you add all of those factors up, you are just literally taking years off your life. If the average expectancy of a male is 78 years old and a truck driver is 63, that's 15 years. Everything I've just said there will easily shed 15 years off your life.
You have chosen this profession. It is very easy to overlook our health. We take it for granted. Keep in mind that we can make choices to better our environment and our health, including the walks, the positive reinforcement with mental health, and the foods that we choose to eat.
I think very ironically, COVID-19 may be changing that culture of low expectation when it comes to health and exercise. You no longer can mill about in the coffee shop eating donuts and drinking coffee on your off time. Now you have to actually probably go to the grocery store and buy your own food to prepare it privately in your truck.
Know how to eat the right food. Don't just run in every stop, run and get a pizza or run to the McDonald's, which things I see all the time. But knowing myself, I stay away from it.
It is clear that maintaining a healthy diet while getting sufficient exercise is the best combination for staying physically healthy as a truck driver. Make sure to prepare healthy foods and plan ahead to get at least some exercise in each day. Please subscribe to our channel for similar trucking content and comment below with your tips on staying healthy while trucking on the road. This is Ronan, and I'll catch you in the next one.